Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today let's take a look at cell formatting in Numbers. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So every cell in a numbers table has a value. How that value is shown depends on the cell formatting. And there are various different types. So here I have some example cells, and if I select any one of them and go to Format Cell, I have it set to Data Format Automatic. It tries to look at the data in the cell and automatically format it. So a number here is just shown as a number. A date is shown as a date. You could always look at the bottom left here to see the actual value. So I could see here that this is 20, this is August 19th, this is August 19th at 9 o'clock. This is 0.5. This is 6D, which means 6 days. It's a duration. If it was text, then it would show up as text instead of a value. Instead of using automatic, you can customize the format here. So let's click on data format, and let's say we want this formatted as number. This won't seem to make any change, but now we have options here. We can have a number of decimals. So it's set to automatic, but I could say I want to force 2 decimals at all times. I could also do the same thing with a number like this and set that to number and force it to 0 decimals. And you can see it rounds that to 6, even though the actual value shown down here is 5.7. You could also use this pull down here to display negative values in different ways. So here a negative value is with a dash. You can have a negative value as red or in parentheses or parentheses and red. And you can also add a 1000 separator. That's definitely something I like to do with numbers like this. You switch to number format, add a 1000 separator, and you get a comma there, at least in the United States, between every 3 digits. Now you can also set the format instead of to number to currency. You have similar options here in terms of decimals and how negatives are represented. And you also have the 1000 separator. But you also can select the currency and change it to something. So you can have dollars or euros, for instance. And you could switch to a counting style, which puts the currency symbol all the way to the left. Now when you use percentage, what it will do is it will take a number like 0.5 and show it as 50%. This could be a little tricky because if you have a number say like 20 and you change that to percentage, it will show it as 2000%, which is correct because 1 is the equivalent to 100%. Now you can also choose to show something as a fraction. So here I have 0.5. I can set that to fraction. And you can see it shows it as 1/2, in other words 1/2. I could set the accuracy up to 1 digit, 2 digits, 3 digits, or just go with things like halves, quarters, eighths, etc. So for this, I could change this to a fraction, and you can see it says 5 7/10. I could switch it to hundredths, and it will show me 70 1/100. I could have it go to quarters, and it's closest to 5 3/4. Now you can also choose numerical systems, although not many people outside of coders have use for this. So I can go to numerical system for 255 here and say I want this to be base 16, and now it's represented in hexadecimal. You can also use scientific notation here. So it makes this number 870 million a little easier to read, especially if you're recording science data here. Now you can set the number of decimals as well. So you can have many different numbers showing the same number of decimal places. Now formatting also works for things like dates. So let's go and set this instead of to automatic to date and time. And now that it's set to that, I can choose a certain format here. So I can go with some long format like that or something short. I can include the year or not include the year in many different formats, or just show just the month or just the year. You also can include the time value. Now, every cell that has a date or time in it has both. So this is August 19th and this says August 19th at 9 a.m. But if I were to switch this to show something with the time, it's going to go and put the time in there. It's just going to be 12 a.m. In this case, I've added an actual time when I typed the value. So it's going to put a time value here and I can choose one of these. Also, you have duration. So you can switch to force this to duration instead of automatic. And you can use automatic units. And you have things like using the letter, which is the actual value. So 6D is 6 days. But I can force it to show 6 days if I want to see that format. But I could also go to custom units here and I could set exactly what's shown. So for instance, I could show days and hours and it would show 6 days, 0 hours, even if there aren't any hours recorded there. I could add minutes, seconds, etc. And then I could choose a style for that so I can just have the letter instead of the whole word for each unit. Now when you're dealing with numbers, if none of these work for you, you could always go to a custom format. So choose Create Custom Format. And it brings up this whole control here. And you can name your custom format. So we'll stick with the default name here. We can go with a number custom format, a date or time or text. So with number, we can have a format like this. And you could drag and drop these things here into the custom format. So for instance, I could add a scale like K. So for this number here, I could go and create a custom format. And I could say use the standard formatting here, drag up K, and now you could see it's 870,000 K. But I could click Edit Custom Format and let's change that to M for millions. And you could see 870 M. There's a lot more you can do here. I could use actual words, hundreds, thousands of millions instead of CK or M. I could add a currency value before this and select the currency value. I could add decimal places right after it and set the number of digits. For the number itself, I click there and there's a lot I could set. For instance, I could show or hide the separator. I could show zeros for unused digits. I can add digits, remove digits, set the number of digits. And I can also add a rule. So when you click here to add a rule, you can have the format change depending upon the value in the cell. So for instance, I could say if the number is less than zero, then put parentheses around this item here. So now if I put negative in front here, you can see it puts those parentheses around there because that's part of my custom format. The rules could be all sorts of things. They could be if it's equal to, if it's less than, if it's greater than. So you can use this as an alternative to conditional highlighting. For instance, here I could go and set a custom format to add a rule and say that if it's equal to 42, put some exclamation points after it, like that. Now you're not going to see any change there, but if I change this number to 42, you can see it does that. And I can easily reuse these custom formats. So let's put a bunch of numbers here. And I can select these cells, change the format to custom format 1, and you can see the number with 42 has those exclamation points after it. So play around with custom formatting to see all the different things that you could do with rules. And you can also use custom formatting for dates. So here you see some complex controls here where you can control exactly how each element is shown. You can drag and drop these up here. You could add text in between things. So if I wanted to create a format that was basically year and then dash and then the month and set that up with leading zeros and a dash and then the day of the month and set that up with leading zeros, I can get a format that looks like that. You can even set a custom format for text. So I could go and create custom format and then all I can have in here is the actual text itself, but I could put something before it. So I could have some text like that, put a little space there, and you can see it says name colon space text, but the actual value is just text. I can double click in here and type something else, and you can see now it displays with that custom formatting. So there's a lot you can do with the regular formatting and a lot you can do with custom formatting. Go ahead and create a sample numbers document and play around with each one of these and see what they can do so you know how they work the next time you need them. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.